thank you for having me here on this incredible event. First year. That's incredible. We're at the ground floor of what hopefully will be many years of successful achievements on behalf of rare diseases, and that we make some strong strides in that regard. I am honored to have been invited to present the Rare Champion of Hope Award to a patient advocate that has become such an important activist for those affected by Duchenne muscular dystrophy. Now, I can tell you personally that activists don't only help those that are afflicted, but the parents of those afflicted as well. More often than not, parents find themselves, as my wife Debbie and I did, in a state of complete confusion, trying to figure out what we do, where do we go, who do we turn to, and it was the 6 weeks that we spent in the intensive care unit at Cedars-Sinai with my daughter, trying to find out what she had, was the most unsettling 6 weeks of our lives. And there are people that are undergoing rare diseases that have this for 6 years. You know, it just, I can't imagine how devastating it must be to those families. However, with a little bit of luck and a lot of work, my wife and I were able to, well, whenever I say we, I really mean my wife, because she is the... She is the cornerstone of our foundation. She's the rock that we all hold on to. She's the captain of our ship, and I am but a lowly seaman. That's a word. All right. So, but with all of the hard work that she has put in and that I have helped her put into helping our daughter, we couldn't have done it alone. We needed people who are out there compelled to help, and people who are selfishly giving their time, people like Pat Furlong. Pat Furlong, a nurse from Middletown, Ohio, learned that her two young sons, Patrick and Christopher, had Duchenne muscular dystrophy, which is a rapid, progressive muscle-wasting disease that lands sufferers in a wheelchair by the time they're in their teens. With no current cure for this disease that affects 20,000 boys globally, patients usually die from cardiac or respiratory failure. Pat Furlong started Parent Project Muscular Dystrophy to spur research for this disease. She has worked effectively in lobbying Congress to pass legislation that has resulted in important financial support for Duchenne research, but has also helped muscular dystrophy in general, and has effectively built an active, engaged community of patient advocates worldwide. She has become widely recognized in the rare disease community as a champion and an advocacy leader who has inspired many to follow in her footsteps. Ladies and gentlemen, I am honored to present to you this year's Rare Champion of Hope Award for patient advocacy to Mrs. Pat Furlong.
It's an honor to be here. I'm from Ohio, and you know we're going to swing the election for good or for bad, and I'll apologize ahead of time if we really mess up. I'm honored to be here. I'm honored to be in the presence of people like John Crowley, Brad Margus, Henry Tamir, Jonathan Jacoby, and I'm in awe of the patients with rare disease. My own sons had Duchenne muscular dystrophy, and they continually impressed me with their wisdom, with their knowledge, with their love. So I wanted to talk to you a little bit tonight about Duchenne muscular dystrophy. Duchenne muscular dystrophy is an X-linked disease. It affects 250,000 worldwide. So that means 250,000 boys, young men in this world have Duchenne muscular dystrophy. 10 to 12,000 of those boys live in the United States. My own two sons were two of them in 1984. Duchenne is caused by the absence of a structural skeletal muscle protein called dystrophin. Dystrophin acts as a communicator, an organizing protein, and it is the shock absorber for muscle. Without dystrophin, muscle can't survive. So in 1984, my little boys were 4 and 6 years old. They looked weak to me. My husband played football for Notre Dame. He was on scholarship with Air Parshijin. He was a big, tall, strapping man, and the 20 doctors that I saw, including my own husband, who's a physician, said I should just not worry because those boys were going to grow into those muscles. And I continually complained. And so I got perhaps my best degree ever, which is called Desperate Crazy Mother. Boys with Duchenne follow a very predictable clinical pattern. At birth, you could notice weakness if you were really observant. The changes are subtle, head lag, and weakness. By the time they're 4 or 5 years old, the weakness is evident. They're really unable to get off the floor. They run in a very awkward gait. And typically, they can't jump with both feet. My sons were diagnosed at 4 and 6 years old by an orthopedic surgeon who took one look at Christopher and said he has Duchenne. What does Patrick look like? And I said, Patrick is the mirror image. And he said, then you have two. I had no family history of Duchenne, but I'm a carrier. Carriers sometimes have symptoms, and I'm lucky enough not to have any at the age of 65, so I'm thankful for that. The clinical course follows that these boys gain skills. They plateau about 7 years old and start on a degenerative path. By the time they're 16, their peers are driving cars, and boys with Duchenne are in wheelchairs. By the time they're 18, and their peers are throwing their arms around various people that they love, these boys can't lift their arms. It's an extraordinary effort to raise a fork to their mouth, to scratch their nose. And most boys at the age of 18 can't do it at all. Usually, they're dead by 30, because the heart is a muscle too, and it fails by the age of 30. My own sons died at the ages of 15 and 17. They died on September 29th and April 29th, 7 months to the day and the hour apart. As people with rare disease, we share so many things in common. First of all, we share the need to identify a gene and its product, protein or enzyme. We need to learn that. We need to understand the pathophysiology of the disease. What happens because that gene is mutated and whatever it's responsible to produce is gone. We need to learn that. And once we learn that, then we look at repurposing drugs or developing new drugs. And then once we get into that, we have to think about moving those into trials, which means we have to think about care and standardizing care, and we have to think about the clinical variability. We have to talk to the regulators about adaptive design so that in clinical trials, everyone with the condition could be involved. But you know, then we depend on outcomes. And outcomes aren't usually validated in rare disease, and they're really hard to tease out benefit because we can't really figure out what's benefit. I can tell you today that the bar for benefit for me would be 5 more minutes to just stare into my lovely son's eyes. I don't think that would get any drug approved. But yet again, we have to talk about those things as we begin to think about clinical trials. We recruit patients, we tease out benefit, we work with regulators, we pass laws and work together on PDUFA 5 and FDASIA. We advocate for the government, we ask the regulators to be flexible, we get drugs approved, and once we get them approved, we're not finished. We have to ensure that every person has access to those drugs. And I think that might be our biggest task. I think it's really, really, really important for all of us in rare disease to know that we're one. And when we work together, we're louder, we're stronger, we're more visible, we're more capable, and we'll be more effective. And I'm always reminded of the story of Horton Hears a Who. You might understand that I spend my time thinking about that elephant who recognized someone very small and said, a person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter the condition, no matter how rare. And together, I believe that we can drive therapies, and I know we will provide access. I can't thank you enough for this award. It's my complete honor. I came into this Duchenne Muscular Dystrophy kicking and screaming. I didn't want to be here. I'm in nursing. I treated adult med-surg. We did transplants. We were heroes. When it comes to a patient with a rare disease, they are our heroes, and they deserve our help. They need our support, and together, we'll make magic for all of them. Thank you, and to all of this, all of us, God bless us all, and Godspeed for therapies. Thank you.